right. Well, they are also on blue side, so we'll see. In some ways, you can take a little bit of initiative in terms of picks and bans. Of course, these days, the meta is diverse enough that you really can take advantages on either side. And so far, just common bans. T1, of course, banning that LeBlanc first, even if they were on blue side when they have Ezyhoon in the booth.
Yeah, they always ban the LeBlanc whenever they play with Ezyhoon. There is the Sivir actually banned by Samsung right here. I anticipated that to come in from SKT. Rek'Sai, of course, a flex pick for Samsung, and Kuvei very good in the top lane. Will result in an Alistar first pick right there, giving the Gragas over to Tom should he want it. So,
all right,
pretty clear idea from Samsung so far. Take away Ezyhoon's two best champions right now and see what he plays. Now, usually Ezyhoon would default to Lulu in this situation, most of the time. Of course, we haven't seen. I mean, his Ziggs, remains elusive. His Ziggs remains elusive.
Yeah.
I'm curious about that because he's always been such a stellar Ziggs player, and yet he hasn't played it even though it's available. So it will be Corki and Gragas, Bang, looking to get his Corki record up to 16-1. Should he win this game? That is a pretty
crazy. Yeah, of course, it's not a huge takeaway from Fury. Fury still has that Lucian available, still could play something like Vayne or Jinx. Of course, the Gragas going over to the other side is going to matter a little bit. Now, what does Eve pick? I mean, Evelynn is available, and so is Sejuani, and so is Fizz, apparently.
Yeah, I don't think they're actually going to go with a Fizz here, but who knows?
I mean, Eve has played quite a bit.
He is 16-1 on Corki, so this would be 17-1 should he take the win. So that's a pretty massive win rate, clearly, 94.1%.
Yeah.
Very dangerous champion. And one of the reasons why it's so dangerous in the hands of SKT is that, first off, they're very good at controlling Dragon early, which is something that Corki excels at. But second off, they've been hitting power spikes incredibly well in the mid-game. Very difficult ones, in fact, like a double AD with a Nunu top, something that really can't do much in the late game. SKT have found ways to just force their advantage on their opponents and then snowball effectively out of that, and it will be Marin's Rumble.
All right. Well, you know, this composition in general has also been pretty common these days. Just so much AP damage coming in, and especially knowing Ezyhoon, I don't think we're going to see a heavy AD in the middle. So this is going to be just a pure magic damage composition pretty much coming in for SKT. T1, Samsung already secured that Maokai, so they have some form of a front line. Alistar also with the percent decreased damage taken is going to help with all the spell damage coming in.
Yeah, I think you definitely go with a Lucian here. The hover for the Varus was not really something you're going to be pulling out, I don't think, against this lane in particular. You want to just bully that Corki out with a Lucian if you can. Could go for an Ahri blind pick, relatively safe in that mid lane.
I would say so. Now, the only danger there is if Ahri falls, even, you know, if even gets solo killed once in lane, that mid game is going to be pretty rough for Samsung. They're not going to have a way to climb back in.
So Ezyhoon just switched to Flash and Ghost, so probably Vlad.
Will we see that Vlad, or will it be the Ziggs? It will probably be the Vlad.
Yeah, as soon as he saw that Ahri locked in, he immediately changed his summoners. Ooh, that would be very interesting.
Well, Ryze has always been a strong counter against Ahri.
That's true.
But of course, this is 5.9, so he's not exactly in the strongest state we've seen him.
Yeah, I think you just go with Vlad here. It's an Ezyhoon staple pick.
Guarantees a late game power. You know, in some ways more so than Ryze in 5.9. And, you know, again, I mean, Vlad synergizes so well with all the AoE damage you have. I mean, you have AoE skills on everyone on SKT T1.
Yeah, Hemoplague and then dropping an Equalizer on them can hurt quite a lot.
And the big one coming in from Corki, that just one single rocket can also do a lot if it's amplified even more. Does already up to 500 damage easily. Just a Trinity Force later on in the game. So it looks like it will be the Vlad lock-in for Ezyhoon in mid. So Crown should have a chance to be able to build up and roam at level 6 if he can just shove it in and not get ganked too easily. But I'm sure Tom will be keeping his eye there in the mid lane, especially with Evelynn being around. Tom's going to have to be busy.
Yeah, this is pretty standard compositions from both sides. A little bit of more pick comp coming in from Samsung right here with the Ahri and the Lucian. They've got some good single target CC as well as the surprise factor with the Evelynn. Meanwhile, SK Telecom They've got good scaling, good AoE, probably a slightly better team fighting, and a little bit better sieging, but these are mostly just very well-rounded compositions.
Yeah.
So Samsung actually not coming in with something wild today, but in general, Samsung has been good at creating picks.
Yes.
That's more their style than the 5v5 team fight. We talk about how they get ahead in these games, especially with Kuve strongly split pushing. Not going to be able to have that luxury against Marin in the top lane this time. Marin very comfortable on Rumble, his most played champion of all time. So that is definitely a staple that he'll be able to deal with in the laning phase, as long as he doesn't do his Marin things and not put down wards.
Yeah, we'll have to keep an eye on that. But yeah, like you said, I think this is overall a really good test for Samsung. You both picked a relatively meta champion, somewhat stable champions, and to your strengths, we'll see how Samsung does in game number one against SKT T1 in our first match of the day. Let's jump right into it. Kick off game number one between Samsung and SKT.
T1 crowd a little more fired up this time, I guess. He's even taking boots first just for some more dodging ability. Very confident that he's going to be able to dodge those charms right here. Wolf with the exhaust to help deal with Crown once he goes in the late game. Yeah, Crown really has shown off a pretty large champion pool this season and done well. It looks like a certain upgrade over Bliss and Ace from the spring season.
I'd have to agree. I think Crown, you know, that diverse champion pool and pretty consistent play. He's not always going to be the hyper carry, but you don't need him to be when you have someone like Fury. So I think Samsung, with this roster lineup, they've really kind of found their color now. They're going to focus on the AD, take a little bit more half utility, half burst champions in mid, and go forth from there.
And Kuve, too, really is developing into a pretty decent top laner as well. After he had so many troubles in the spring season, Samsung stuck with him, and now he's shown that he can be a big lane bully, especially on these lane bully champions like Rek'Sai. He was just driving down the turrets against Jhin Air, even got an inhib turret with his split pushing. And it's Samsung definitely looking on the up and up in spite of their 1-3 record so far. They have had some pretty difficult opponents.
Yeah, that is true. So we'll yet another tough opponent here, of course, probably the toughest one in Korea right now. SKT T1 looking to climb back into their prime, more or less.
So early ward right here during the lane swap, going down at the blue buff so they can track Eve's movements just a little bit. Weak side jungle. But since SK Telecom started at the blue buff instead of at the Grump, that doesn't give Wraith any time to start harassing them with the Alistar. And if you're going to weak side jungle in a lane swap, that's how you do it. You start buff, you don't start Grump, you don't start Krugs, because that gives the support time to walk in and start screwing with you. You don't want that. Instead, they're going to go blue to blue. Very interesting. Tom was allowed to hit level 2. He got all the XP off the blue buff. So only level 1 for this Rumble. Now they're going to get seen. What can Eve do here, if anything?
Waiting for the smite, and Kuve's going to come down first, so it is a 2v2.
Actually, Alistar's here too.
All right, Alistar here from base, so it is a 3v2 for now, and SKT does just have to back out. Will they get caught? Kuve standing up front. There's a double pulverize coming in from Wraith, but that is going to be just about it.
Yeah, they're, I mean, with Bang and Wolf just walking down from the top side on that, there wasn't too much pressure that Samsung was able to put on. Tom also, I believe, got the smite steal on that.
Yeah, I think he did. And so he will be taking that blue buff. Just a shout out to some chocolate by our fan.
I was like, ABC chocolate? What?
It's a brand, I'm not sure. I'm not sure what's going on there.
Shout out to chocolate, everybody.
Everybody can use some chocolate.
I think this guy is not in the right place right now. I think he's confused. It's not actually a cooking show.
Well, easy Yoon so far, just holding strong. And, you know, the boots also going to help against Aura Deception and Crown, if he was given the chance, would have loved to harass as much as he could with that and shove the lane in, but EZ1 going to try to prevent that as much as possible with his item pickups. Eve taking some damage, but poking
really
on the side, and
Bang's
just going to come in. There's a flash exhaust from SKT, and Bang just one more auto attack. He picks up the red buff, and he won't even bother looking at Kuvei, just going to go back and secure all the CS.
Doesn't even auto Kuvei, knows that he can't kill him, but that was really dangerous to have two melee champions against Corki and Janna on the top side of the map right there. She does have that ability to really power up Bang, and they wanted to push it out to prevent it from being frozen off the wave, but Janna in the brush, and that turns into a pretty big disaster.
Yeah, I think Samsung also not respecting enough that SKT will go all in on that with all of their summoners being used, all four, in fact, used on SKT to secure that first blood and a red buff for Bang.
Marin trading pretty aggressively there, all things considered. Does get out, though he is a little bit the worse for wear now. Wolf coming in to the bottom side to help him out in terms of his CS. Kuvei did have a CS advantage based on that situation, as Marin was all by his lonesome, but playing a lot more safely and just letting himself be denied right there. Eve now wanting to deal with his Raptors. Tom already there.
Yeah, Eve just wants to go in. They both have a smite, so Eve, if he wants to secure it, he's going to have to use a smite. And Tom just trying to calculate his barrel damage on his own. And there's the flash over from Crown and the charm. Tom jumps over with the flash and then body slams away. The ignite is not going to be enough. Wraith coming in. And he flashes over for the pulverize, gets the auto attack, picks up the kill.
Great play from Wraith, using the headbutt to get in range. And Tom sometimes likes to overcommit to things. This is the downside to Tom, is he loves fighting, he loves scrapping it out.
Yeah.
He's always in your face, and that can go awry, especially when Crown is able to just commit to that with the flash and get the charm.
Yeah, I mean, that's why you see when Tom wins, like, he'll win very handily because he can really dominate the enemy jungle, but
he is a bit of a gambler.
Absolutely.
But that's a nice response from Samsung. Wraith heading up there to help out and secure that kill. Fortunately for SKT, the kill goes on to Wraith, so that red buff not on a more dangerous laner.
Yeah, it's not going to see too much use on that melee support. But it's just nice to secure the extra golden experience for his teammates, even up the kill score a little bit. Samsung is a little bit behind because of the first blood extra gold and some other differentials, especially in the mid lane here. Oh, and even in bottom, actually, in terms of CS.
Yeah, AD carry. Bang has been able to pick up quite a bit more. I think Fury and Wraith were a little bit preoccupied with harassing out Marin.
Yeah, I'd have to agree. Bang, of course, got the kill off of that trade in top. Came back with the red buff.
And swapping back now, Bang has that sheen from the first blood quite early on. He's going to be stronger than Fury at this stage. Also just hit six, so he's finally able to poke out Fury just a little bit. Now this roam has been detected by the wards.
Nope, now Eve is coming in. Eve was not detected yet. No pink ward in that tribe rush, but Crown has been seen, so SKT just going to try to play it safe. Will they wait until Tom comes by? It looks like he might be a little low on mana by the time he comes down, so I think SKT is just going to try to draw out as much time as possible. Crown confirms that he was down there, so easy and comfortably just beating down on this tower little by little.
Yeah, they suspected too. I mean, with all their movement, summoners down, both flashes on Bang and Wolf. You don't want to put yourself in harm's way, even if Wraith's flash is also down, so he can't make quite such an impressive play. They're still struggling to get six right here,
wow.
So Fury is really getting bullied. There he goes, finally with the six.
Yeah, but Bang really just shoving him out nonstop. And Crown, because of a lot of these other movements, hasn't really been able to farm as comfortably nor harass EZ1 out of the lane. And at this point, EZ1's not going to get bullied out of lane. With that revolver already in hand, already level 7, he has enough sustain to deal with that Ahri harass should it come through.
Eve taking a look at his blue buff right now. No wards there from SKT. Should be a pretty safe takeaway. And EZ1 just quietly getting pretty big on this Vladimir in the mid lane. He's out of really the Vladimir danger zone for the most part, which is before Vlad can really trade effectively, he could take quite a bit of punishment. But now that he approaches that level 5 in this transfusion, he's going to be able to keep himself constantly topped up in the laning phase.
SKT's duo lane and bottom looking for a very aggressive trade in the brush here, but they're just going to get checked by Fury with his W. Meanwhile, mid lane Crown is kind of running out of time in terms of getting an advantage that Ahri usually really needs. Oh, and in top lane, Eve comes in for a gank, and there's the flash, but Twisted Advance comes in afterwards, the ultimate from Kuvei, and oh, the explosive cast almost saves him, but double flash blown from Samsung to secure the kill.
Yeah, used a lot right there, though.
And
one more summoner, bang.
Dodges Howling Gale, but the exhaust, not enough damage. Without the exhaust, Bam would have died. He still has a Valkyrie out because of the Ignite coming in from Wraith, and also just taking a lot of culling damage even with the exhaust.
And there you go. There's that sustain from Alistar too. Wraith still very threatening at that full HP, and his combo going to be back up soon. Already is back up, in fact. So that means Fury and Wraith, they love to play aggressively in these lanes, and they find themselves a bit of an edge. As a result, they're really catching up in terms of gold now, nearly equalizing with that kill onto Marin. And Marin really hasn't been able to get a lot of CS in this top side, actually. Kuvei doing some work on him already, and with that Spectre's Cowl, Marin not really much of anything right now. Null Magic Mantle and an Amp Tome. He is in no shape to 1v1 this tree.
No, not at all. He's going to need a lot more time and a lot more gold to get there. But thankfully, of course, Ezhiyun is kind of that backup plan for SKT, and he's been growing just fine. 90 CS so far. Quietly, no deaths. Has it Revolver, just going to keep on farming as long as he can. Now Eve looking for a possible gank in bottom or just scouting out where Tom is, gets a deep ward while he's at it, so he'll spot Tom soon. Now Eve finds the pink ward in a little danger, thanks to his ward over the wall, finds Tom, just backs out, at least he's aware of the pink ward now. The top lane, I mean, still pretty rough for Marin. He either needs help from his teammates need to make something happen elsewhere. Just using that equalizer to get some damage, and Kuvei actually taking a little more from the equalizer than he needs to, but Marin's main point was, of course, just to clear the minion wave and back out.
Yeah, he needs to go back and buy right now, see what he can get to stick around in that lane. Ezhiyun trying to delay, actually takes a tower shot right there. Crown having no intentions to go back. Look at the pink wards around the mid lane also.
Yeah.
They are really trying to let Ezhiyun push forward now. He's going to start getting more points into his Tides of Blood, which means he can wave clear and push this Ahri back. And they want to make sure there's not going to be anyone coming in from the flank to deal with them. Tom also just sitting protecting wards right now. Their goal is to take out the mid lane turret as fast as possible. Look at how far Ezhiyun is pushing forward.
Yeah, I mean, he's been playing just very comfortably with that extra backup from his jungler in terms of vision and actual physical support. And Tom gonna take this opportunity to just start the dragon. They saw the rest of Samsung kind of back out from the bottom half of the map. So they'll just continue it with Ezhiyun coming down from the mid lane.
No Lucian, no Ahri, no threat here for SK Telecom. Easy, easy first dragon of the game here in 12 minutes. And they're going to be able just to go right back into mid and keep pushing up. That turret in mid lane has been taking so much damage. Crown left a couple times while Ezhiyun was there. And Crown just hasn't found a good roam yet, really.
Yeah, that's what you really need, especially against Vladimir, as anyone, really. It's so hard to kill him straight up on your own because he has that pull. He usually does take those two movements, summoner spells. And Ahri finally moving on up. I mean, Rumble is the easiest target, especially with his flash down. Now, hasn't been spotted just yet, sticking close to the far wall, but Rumble just backs out. Marin playing it super safe. Of course, there is that ward in mid, so Crown coming back to just clear that one out.
And SKT making the decision to sacrifice Marin here. Look at the bottom side wards that they've managed to get. They want to keep pushing up with Corki and Vladimir. Corki getting close to that Trinity Force where he will be able to actually take down a turret. Vlad also dangerously close to taking out the mid lane. And Marin, you know what? He's going to do damage at this point of the game, whether or not he has very many items or not. So just go for the tower pressure and the immediate gold. Let Marin sit in the top side, farm as best he can. But you're putting a lot of emphasis right now onto the mid and bottom lanes for SKT.
Yeah, well, given that Rumble was having a tough time early on anyway, this is going to allow them to kind of skip that slump from Vladimir in the mid game. Of course, Corki just going to hit it right on time in terms of his Triforce, actually a little bit earlier probably at this rate. And so Eve and Wraith looking for a way to stop that on the bottom side of the map. With Wraith being still visible to all wards, SKT should be aware that something fishy is up. They saw him go in. Wraith actually just going to march all the way through. They're going for the long plan here, and there is the Flash Pulverize to ensure that he can knock him back with the headbutt, but a nice Valkyrie and the Monsoon coming. Kuvei comes in with the Teleport. Fury picks it up with the Culling. Equalizer blocking the escape from Fury and Kuvei, but the Teleport coming in time from Kuvei is going to help pick up that kill. Ezion trying to look for an angle, but they've already retreated far enough to avoid that Hemo Plague.
No. Right now, they should just push mid. SKT should just keep on pushing mid while there's no threat. They had four people in the bottom side. Get back to your lanes. Punish Samsung for all the farm that they've lost. Yeah, nice. Delay the recalls as well, if possible. It was a good kill from Samsung. Very unexpected strategy, but there's also so much you can lose in those situations in terms of CS and in terms of pressure. And Ezion motioning down there, I think, was a bit unnecessary.
Yeah, Ezion, I mean, unless he had left as soon as the fight started, was going to be a little difficult for him to pick up a kill. Meanwhile, Blue Buff going to be transferred over to Crown in the mid lane. Crown also still not finding a good chance to really make anything happen.
Goodbye, tower.
Yeah, the tower is going to go down now. Vladimir picks up that last hit. Ezion knocking down the tier one, and Ezion is just super happy with how this game is going.
Yeah, it's actually going much better for SK Telecom. We do see them with that gold lead, but they have so much control, and Samsung is sort of swinging wild haymakers at the bottom lane right now. Well, SKT only kind of getting clipped by them, but mostly dodging, and they are able to counter with something far more meaningful.
Yeah, Tom, after that first little mishap at the Raptors, has also been really consistent around the mid lane, securing that vision that we discussed earlier. Now Wraith starting to move around a little bit more too, especially with that tier one down in mid. Samsung really has to be concerned about how far Ezion pushes up and what other advantages SKT can get from that. And in the top side, Marin hasn't really fallen any more behind than he was before, so that's really good news. Did pick up the home guards though, so still doesn't really have too much extra damage from items. And even the bottom lane once again, Wraith doesn't have flash.
So Marin, home guards first, every time. Not even finishing the Haunted guys, just wants that ability to get back into lane at his leisure and to make plays with his teleport, which will be up for a little bit, but
Bang is going to be able to pressure out Fury every time for quite a while now. Rage is going to get caught by Wolfie. They're going to get slowed down. There's a Zephyr coming in. Tom walking down, but they get spotted. They're just going to back out. They can continue shoving out that mid lane now that they know where two of the members of Samsung are. There's the charm from over the wall. Crown can't all in, though, to seeing Ezion in mid, and his backup is pretty far. Another deep ward from Tom. I mean, Samsung simply can't do much. They've been choked out in the bottom half of the map.
Yeah, well, we'll see what happens around this next dragon, but the vision already in place for SKT. Not a whole lot of wards set up for Samsung, and it's going to be a situation that Marin will have his TP up. Not sure. Kuvei looking like his might still be down for when this starts.
Yeah, it'll be a little iffy. It might come up right as it starts, but being there a second earlier makes a big difference when you want to set up your skills, especially something like Equalizer that can also deny the teleport in easily from Kuvei. Kuvei does have that Righteous Glory though, so whenever he does get there, he'll be able to join the fight very quickly for Samsung.
Well, here we go. Setup starting right about now. Just going to go ahead and clear out a pink ward in the river. Kuvei try and defend this. Nope, decides not to. Only one hit left. Marn will drop his trinket in that brush, and Samsung finally got some more wards around the pit right there. Ezion just farming out the Raptor camp while he can.
Yeah, and Samsung, yeah, like you mentioned, they got some semblance of vision around the dragon pit, but they're still not in position first to really make anything happen. They're just waiting to see what SKT does, and that
Bang's
means
not
still
there.
Bang is a little ways away, so SKT not going to start the dragon just yet. I mean, they know that Samsung's not going to start just yet either. And Kuvi's just going to go ahead and walk down. He doesn't want to risk anything. His teleport is down for a little bit longer. Samsung looking for a pinch around the entire pit. But they're spending a lot of time now. I mean, Marin, with that teleport available, he's just going to quietly shove down the top lane. And Samsung's going to now be forced to make a choice sometime very soon. Easy and prepared to join the fight as soon as possible. Bang shoving out the bottom lane. And yeah, Samsung, I mean, they thought about starting. It looks like they are just going to go ahead and do it. Marin's going to go home. He picks up a Blasting Wand. had that Haunting Guys. His teleport is available. Home Guard on the Rumble. Samsung goes ahead and starts the Dragon. Where's the teleport? Marn actually left base. He's going to go back, charge it up. The teleport coming in from the Rumble right above the pit. And Tom just pushes everyone out with the explosive cast. Dragon gets reset. Tom's up front. The Equalizer actually shuts out Wraith and Tom on opposite sides. Fury picks the first kill onto Tom. Wraith is hemoplated along with three other members, but Fury is safe at full health. Ezio gets charmed, but Fury a little too far to do damage. That Rumble and the Corki Poke coming out over the entire fight. Fury can't turn around. There's a burst from the Lucian, but it's not enough. He dodges the Phosphorus Bomb. Ezio chasing after him. Wraith a little too scared to go help him unless it's absolutely necessary. Look at the burst from the Vladimir. Flash forward from Bang, but there's the Headbutt Pulverize. Ezio picks up the kill onto Fury. Eve picks up the kill onto Bang, and Marin now just diving through. He wants one more Harpoon or the Flame Spitter, and he's gonna go ahead and get the double kill for the ace.
Wow, ace right there as SKT turns it around. Bit risky, the Dragon actually living through all of that as the SKT sort of hung around the back poking while Tom got a little bit too far forward there. Dragon sort of flashed back into the pit. That was a little bit crazy. But the cleanup and the sustained damage from Vladimir and the Corki Poke, really the hero in that fight. As we take a look at this, Tom's gonna go in, knock Eve against the wall right there. Now they're trying to burst it, and I'm not exactly sure what happens to the Dragon right here. Interesting. But the Equalizer actually gives them a little bit more time. There's the pop from the Hemo Plague. They want to go in. Ezihoon already with the Negatron Cloak, though, isn't going to take that much damage from Crown's attempt at it all in. Then after that, no hesitation, flashing forward, getting the damage, and then following it through with the tower dive. We've got another Dragon fight going on.
Yeah, and this time the teleport coming in from Kuve, so SKT now defending the Dragon. But here comes Marn from the side with the flank. Ezihoon just used his pull, so that is down. Dragon going very low, and Eve gets the steal, and Samsung looks like they just want to get out of the Equalizer onto Fury. He's completely shut out of the fight. There's the culling onto Tom. It pushes him back, and the Twisted Event secures the kill, but Ezihoon comes in with the Hemo Plague. He's going to chase after two people. Can't catch either one, though, as Kuve tries to run away. He's going to be harpooned down. There's a Flame Splitter. He will have to be sacrificed, I think. Charm not going to hit. Oh, the Warden, the Twisted Event's over, and that forces Marin to have to use his Flash. And there's the passive again for Kuve. He's just trying to use as many skills to get his passive back up. Some neat little tricks for Kuve. Eventually goes down, though.
Yeah, Marin does have to commit a summoner spell to that in the end. See, Tom came back with the Aegis of the Legion, really doing a lot of work, especially since Fury isn't very strong at this stage. Still 3-1-1 in this game as his team falls behind. And with that, SK Telecom just brute forcing their way from two back-to-back fights into a 5,000 gold lead. Even though they eventually lose that Dragon, they actually did trade the bottom tower for it after the first ace.
Yeah, so, I mean, and all the ultimates were out. Hemo Plague, Equalizer was up again, and the Equalizer right along the wall. Really beautiful from Marin, shutting Fury out. He eventually got the kill with the culling from afar, but that was literally the only damage Fury did that whole fight.
Well, Marin's Equalizers in the last fight have been really good. The first one, if that Dragon had, popped back into the pit, it was just there designed to keep them at bay until they could actually kill the Dragon. A little bit of miscommunication with Tom, who I think went too far in if that was going to be their goal.
You
need that spike there, and it was kind of awkward. But in the second fight, wanting to take it after the Dragon Steal by Eve and instead forcing the issue and just eliminating Fury from the fight. Remember that they're all itemized for magic resistance right now, not for attack damage.
Yeah.
So by removing Fury from the fight, they're able to actually increase the efficiency of their items in these little skirmishes. And they were easily able to clean up under those circumstances.
Yeah, and with two Abyssal Scepters, Corki's pretty much guaranteed to have some extra magic damage shred onto the enemy team with his poke. So Corki's going to feel pretty good about that. Bang, able to do more damage before he even gets his Sork Shoes, because one of Rumble or Vlad is going to be in the front lines doing damage and getting that aura down.
Yep, and now the Baron setup begins. Pretty early in this game for a Baron setup, but it's just about that three towers to none right now for SK Telecom. They've been able to just harass the outer ring with their earlier siege with the Trinity Force, and also Ezihoon's relentless lane pressure in the early game. A lot of this, the credit should go to Ezihoon here for how much he did out of the laning phase.
Yeah, I mean, he's been putting out so much pressure, and again, I mean, when you play that Ahri against really anyone, you are playing on a pretty short clock. If you don't get an early pressure advantage, the enemy will eventually catch back up to you, and especially when it's someone like Vladimir. I mean, he's 106 now, 40 CS ahead of his counterpart, and has Will of the Ancients on top of an Abyssal Scepter, and will soon get his Zhonya's. He's going to be unstoppable as we go into the 30-minute mark in a few minutes. Fury finally has that eye on top of the static shiv, so some wave clear coming out from him, some damage, especially since they don't have too much armor on the other side, but that only matters if he can get into the fight.
Yes, indeed. Well, a lot of milling around the Baron right now.
Baron, no flash. Yeah, they saw that, so they're just going to go ahead and knock him back with the Twisted Advance, and there's the teleport coming in. He already used his... Oh, and he will complete it at the very end, just teleporting just a couple feet back with about 300 health.
Yeah, but the Baron already started by SK Telecom quite a while ago, actually. They're trying to burn it down. Tom taking quite a few hits.
Razor's gonna knock Ezion back. Ezion has to use the pool to escape, and he just uses his ultimate unbreakable will to escape out of that one. Hemoplay comes through, forces him back, but now the rest of Samsung has grouped up, so SKT is gonna have to give this one up for now.
Well, Vlad wasn't there for a lot of that Baron attempt. SKT making the right call, and Samsung countering nicely. Kuve getting up after that attempted gank. The shot calling from Samsung has actually been pretty good on what to do against SK Telecom in this situation. They nullified that TP advantage, and now Kuve is going to have his teleport up in just a matter of seconds. Will SKT try and focus him down, make the play onto the TP split pusher without giving up that Baron?
Yeah, you know, I'm trying to figure out how many times Ezion has used his flash, if at all, this game. Because, I mean, he used it
in the first Dragon fight.
All right, the first one. That's what I thought.
He flashed forward when Bang Val.
Oh, right, yeah.
During the chase.
But other than that, I mean, he's been so safe by just using the Ghost to get that extra damage and the mobility. He's been able to pull, and he can therefore pull pretty liberally early on because he can rely on that flash to get out of emergency situations if he needs. And that says a lot about just how these team fights will continue to look for SKT.
Well, here come Fury and Eve, but they are spotted out by a pink ward in the brush. And that means
Marin's
going to recall. Let Samsung get their first turret in the game. He's not concerned. They still have a major lead here. And with the dragon up in 14 seconds, frankly, they'll be happy to see three people on the top side.
Yeah, and Samsung looking for a pick, but they're not really going to find one. I mean, Marin shows up just to put the equalizer down. Yeah, that's going to stop the shove in, and only 2 seconds left on that dragon. SKT is going to get a free dragon here at 27 minutes, puts them at 2 stacks. And yeah, Samsung finally realizing what's going on. They ping that top side, but no minions. I mean, how are you going to take it? Sure, you can try to tank it, but SKT's done with the dragon by now.
You have to wait for a long time on that. Wolf is going to recall. They're going to try and make a play onto Crown, valking in.
Yeah,
forcing
Crown
that Spirit Rush to be used, and they can just push mid and respond with a tier 2 of their own.
Yeah.
Not really a way that now that Crown's ult is down and he's chunked out for them to defend a tier 2. It's already very low. Bang is going to stay there while they defend the inhibitor turret. Everyone else going back. Bang, the one designated to take down the tower.
Yeah,
he's gonna
Eve
get
is here though, so he slows down Bang, and Bang's going to put down the Foster's Bomb, denying Crown any extra damage. Eve has to back out. They'll look at the poke coming back out from Bang. A little too dangerous. Again, Crown, if he had that Spirit Rush, that would have been an easy kill onto Bang.
Yeah, but they felt absolutely comfortable letting Corki sit there, considering the circumstances.
Wraith
looking for the Bobby boots.
He's marching forward. The flash is available for Bang, and there is the headbutt and the pulverizer leading into the charm. Bang staying a little too long after Eve distracted
him.
Yeah,
take the tower, then leave. Go through the enemy jungle if you have to. Marin was busy pushing up the bottom wave that entire time. So it's going to be pretty safe for you on the bottom side of the map, even if you walk through a scary dark jungle, considering you knew that all of them were just in the top side. So a bit of a mistake there from Bang, not choosing the safest pathing to where his top laner was under those circumstances.
Well, it's just the bane of being an AD carry. So often do you not see the ideal path of escape. Only see enemies you can kill. Numbers to add on your scoreboard as Marin, I mean, he's completely stabilized by now ahead, and CS 4-1 and 2 has that Rylai's on top of the Abyssal Scepter. The Rumble Vladimir synergy is complete, really. Izonia is now there for Ezreal also.
That's huge. The Rylai's combined with the pool from Vladimir underneath them, you can stack up so much AoE damage.
Yeah, and then the Hemo play, the Equalizer. I mean, if Samsung groups wrongly just one time, they're going to all get deleted by two champions on the enemy side.
Yeah, as you mentioned, too, the Corki missile is also going to be piling on, even though there is a Locket already. Eve prioritizing that naturally against the massive amount of AP on SK Telecom after finishing his Warrior enchantment.
Yeah, but this is just such a safe way to play that Corki, because he does have a very short auto attack range. Rarely are you relying on that for the damage, but this guarantees that, in fact, you are just going to do more damage from afar with your rockets.
I'm very impressed with how much Samsung got better during the offseason. Their shot calling and map control has improved tremendously. Even though they fell behind in some of these team fights, they got outplayed around the SK Telecom power spike, something that SK Telecom is very good and doing to teams these days. Ever since then, their damage control to prevent SKT from taking that Baron or taking unreasonable leads out of a split push has been deftly turned away by Samsung Galaxy.
Yeah, only, you know, 6K, it's quite a bit, but compared to the 5K burst that SKT got earlier after the Dragon fights, Samsung has stabilized a decent amount. Fury going in onto Ezreal, and there's a Charming Knight onto the Vladimir. Culling coming out, and can he get the damage onto Ezreal? Ezreal doesn't find the right angle of escape, and Fury picks up the kill. What a good combo between Crown and Fury.
Fury is so good at hitting the Culling. That's something that we've seen from his Lucian play for the last several months, ever since he got back into the professional team, of course, formerly on Prime. And his dashing forward on Lucian, his aggressive use of his ultimate has really paid off, and he got a perfect angle right there.
Yeah, Ezreal really wasn't escaping that. Ezreal used Ghost too, and that's why he was slightly ahead.
Ezreal could have lived if he had used Flash.
If he had used Flash, yeah, that's true.
He got a little bit greedy, and Fury barely got that kill at the end of the Culling, so Ezreal just a miscalculation right there.
Yeah, I think Ezreal also miscalculated how much longer he had left on the Culling, because Ezreal kind of stopped his escape. He had Ghost, so he was missing one or two shots in the middle there because of the movement speed difference. But eventually, Fury still picks it up. He keeps his Culling lined up to the very end, so credit to him. 4-1 and 1 now. So Fury, although had a rough start, he's now just doing completely fine, even in gold with the enemy Corki, and is going to start to hit very hard as that AD power. And Tom finally building some armor, and now also has a Warden's Mail, so that's pretty good news, but doesn't have the complete Frozen Heart yet.
Samsung can keep getting back in this game too, as long as they make picks.
Yeah.
They have all the tools to do it. Samsung has a lot more wards on the map at the moment. They have good vision control. They can absolutely punish a member of SKT should they get out of position. And if they can take another turret down here, they have two outer ring turrets. That's going to put them within a very reasonable striking distance in terms of global gold to get back into this game. And they can move through them pretty quickly right now. Jonas Shield coming in, but still some damage applied to that tier one tower.
Yeah, Corki showing up in time to help clear out that wave is going to matter quite a bit. But 30 seconds left on Dragon. Samsung starts to get some vision around the Dragon Pit, and this time they're going to have that advantage. Kuvei has that teleport, so does Marin. So both of them are in the top lane. Marin just going out to make sure that Kuvei doesn't get too much of a shove in towards the inhibitor turret in top. Those are the only two turrets going down in favor of Samsung at the moment.
And this Maokai, I'm starting to get very scared of if I'm on SKT, because he's going to be able to tank out the damage from SKT so efficiently here. Vladimir, of course, does great sustained damage, but that damage reduction from Maokai and the fact that he is stacking up more MR means that...
Uh-oh.
Okay, yeah, so we have a flank.
Marin's ready for a really good equalizer if he gets... He's just hiding in the brush. And is it coming down? Fury's across the wall, so Fury's completely out of the fight, and Bang goes in with the Blade of the Ruin King. He's going to chase him down with the Flash, and Bang gets an easy kill. Marin, job well done, just backs out, draws the entire Samsung team away from the Dragon Pit. And Kuve is just too late. Didn't find an angle to use his teleport because of the pinch coming in from SKT.
Well, he was trying to walk down, but SKT was already set up. They preemptively teleported, had Marin there just waiting in the brush. And again, Marin gets a great separation equalizer to just keep Fury off of his team. Kuve now having to run quite a long way, gets the smash down on the Bang and slows him up enough to escape. He has TP if he wants to go onto this Baron with the crab there. Not really sure SKT is going to be able to secure that objective.
Yeah, I mean, they still don't have eyes on Eve. Marin doesn't have his teleport anymore. They know that Kuve still has his, so I think it definitely wasn't worth the risk. They're
coming.
Actually just going to go ahead. Kuve coming in with the home guard, easy and right there. There's the explosive cask on top of the pool to deny that, but Righteous Glory onto Tom with the Twisted Advance. They will pick up one kill onto the Gragas. Wraith goes in to make sure Bang doesn't do too much damage to his teammates. And Twisted Advance back in onto three people. Crown comes in with the Spirit Rush. He's doing a lot of damage,
Fury.
But there is the exhaust. And Bang coming in, he's out of mana. Ezion had to use his zone. Yes, Fury has rejoined. He's at full health. There's the equalizer. Does quite a bit. Fury doesn't have a way to escape. He has to walk all the way around. And that's going to be the end of that fight for now. But Marn's not done yet. He knows he can do quite a bit of damage. He's going to try to harass Eve. Eve will still pick up the Raptors.
Marin.
All right, he will get out. The ward saves him as Fury finds one target first. Marin is sitting on a ward, though.
Calling.
And, all right. Well, the angle there, it is a little rough. He had to get the first hit right on. And Eve, of course, already used her ultimate.
All right. Well, SKT does escape from that. But as far as trades go at this point in the game, Samsung doing quite well for themselves in order to grab a kill and then keep the fight rolling. Fury's actually pretty strong in this game. The big difference is with Ezhoon, actually. It's about a 2K gold lead, and now that he's got that voice staff, he really needs a Zhonya's Hourglass to help out against Fury, though.
Oh, and Tom comes in and forces the Unbreakable Will from Wraith. Thankfully, no one from Samsung getting stunned by the Body Slam, but that's a very important ultimate use from Samsung.
Yeah. QSS now for Fury also, trying to... What is he trying to QSS? I guess
Hemoplague. Yeah. I mean, I think that's the main concern. Sure, you can QSS the slows from Rumble or something like that, but the biggest thing here is damage amplification, especially for
could
the rockets.
Could be for exhaust too.
That also. Yeah, so I mean, there are all these other combinations that he wants to QSS for sure.
Yeah, they're probably going to exhaust Ahri though, so that's not as much of a concern. The QSS here is a little odd, but at least it gives him some MR as well against a majority. That's probably the most important thing,
yes,
is the MR, actually.
I think, yeah, and on top of that, it builds into a damage item at the end instead of a Banshee's Veil, where you know that you have to carry all the damage burden late game for Samsung.
Still trying to get this turret right now. This would be another outer turret for Samsung, if they could.
Should be able to get it here with Fury, using his passive wisely, and they'll just chunk it down. So Samsung's still basically keeping up in this game, and like you mentioned, Monty, if they keep just getting one or two kills each fight and then backing out or getting those picks on the sides for SKT, they could very well win the game. And SKT, on the other side, of course, has been playing around that very well. They've been setting up the flanks first with Marin with the equalizer. So if the equalizers keep up like that, Samsung's going to have a hard time getting the fight they want.
The main problem with SKT is that their warding really hasn't been very good this game. They constantly find themselves in situations where they can get picked off. They are outplaying their performance, their opponents a little bit. Looks like Wraith not going to have to pop the Unbreakable Will. A little bit of a dicey situation, but not punished for it.
Oh, a nice equalizer just to get some damage onto Samsung. Pops the locket, but that's all about it. I mean, they weren't really set up to go forward with the damage, so that also just doubling as a vision check and forcing Samsung out of there so that SKT could go in and get some vision back. Of course, equalizer, relatively low cooldown. If you're pretty confident you don't have to fight anytime soon yet, Dragon's still a minute 40 left. Marin using that to gain some vision on the top side.
I don't get why Marin is trying to actually pull off that equalizer right now. SKT has teleport advantage. They should definitely be split pushing at the moment and trying to make the most out of it instead of awkwardly ulting in the jungle on something that the rest of the team can't really follow up on, especially since they didn't have deep enough wards to really pull that off. I think that this is definitely the better call. Look at that tier two in the bottom side. Set your sights on that objective and then force Kuve to be down there when he can't respond as well as you can to some Baron pressure.
Yeah, we see the pings going down from Samsung, but really who's going to go answer that at this point? They are pretty concerned about the Baron. Kuve has still some time left on his teleport. Now the turret is pretty healthy, but it's a pretty big mini-wave, and it'll keep stacking up.
His TP will be back by the time he gets down there to clear out that wave, so that's actually some pretty good timing. Marin designated to clear out this very large wave in the top side, and you remember the laning phase. Look at the CS differential between Marin and Kuve now after how far behind Marin was earlier on. It's because he's just been pushing and pushing this entire game and been the one to take all of that farm.
Yeah, what a monster. And he's always been a really good split pusher, but the big difference here is that his teleports have improved immensely since they joined into one team under SKT T1. And he's been able to really have a presence in the team fights. Wolf's going to get caught by Fury, but doesn't take too much damage thanks to Eye of the Storm with that shield. And also Fury not getting the full hit because of the very quick movement speed from Wolf.
He's lucky he didn't get super chunked out right there. Dragon is live. SKT has a positional advantage, but no crab. Speed Shrine in favor of Samsung.
Rocket's already doing some damage onto Wraith, and Wraith is really concerned about that Vladimir flank too right now. Wraith is very busy. He needs to look on both ends of the fight constantly along with Kuve.
Kuve's going for a teleport flank here. They want to fight this.
All right, well, Eve's also there. Eve has a really good flank, but he's way too far ahead of the entire team. There comes Kuve from the side, and Eve is pretty tanky, so Kuve shows up. Bang doesn't get the kill. Kuve now Righteous Glory is done, but there's the Ghost coming in as Marin now shows up from the side and he gets some good harpoons. There is a beautiful equalizer. Wraith has been completely separated. Oh, he might still be able to get out though. He flashes out in Fury, now free to do damage onto Marin. Marin just jumps onto him with that Flame Spitter and there's a slow coming in from Wolf. Ezio gets snared in the back. Fury pretty low, has to use that QSS to run away, and oh, Marin uses the Zonias at the very end. Can they secure the kill? Nice Monsoon to secure that. Tommy on the side of the fight at the very bottom picks up a kill onto Eve. Everyone low on Samsung. Ezio looking for a chase. No summoners on either side. Fury should be able to dash out at the last minute. Four Dragon Snacks for SKT. Uh-oh, Bang's looking for a rocket. I think Bang flashed into the wall right there. He just wanted to auto that for the kill, but Bang's just gonna move on up. Still not find an angle onto Crown. Bang a little greedy with that flash.
And that could have been such a good engage from Samsung had Eve waited about 2 seconds more for the TP to come in from Kuve. It was a timing issue that caused Eve to really blow his ultimate early and for Kuve not to be able to find the flank. So pretty poor execution from Samsung. That's going to result in a Baron. If we just look at this, well, we missed the big mistake here from Samsung, and Tom sticks onto the Dragon. He tries to get it. Tom, not going to have any of that, just smites it away. Eve tries to flash out, and there is a flash from Tom.
Nice play from Tom.
Just to bounce him back, too. That was a really good play.
Yeah, well done. And of course, the rest of the fight is just a long chase onto Fury where they don't get a kill. But yeah, you know, and that's the thing with flanks we always talk about is that it requires so much precision timing, because if you mess up, what else we saw happen was then Eve has to back out, drawing the fight even further away from his team, and it's just really not an ideal fight at all for Samsung.
Well, Easy Hoon has 833 AP, which because of Vlad's passive means that he also has 3,400 HP.
Beautiful.
And nobody's going to be killing him anytime soon.
Yeah, this is a problem you face with Vladimir, is that you can't kill him anytime soon, but he does sustain damage, so you can't let him live for too long either. Just a catch 22 at that point. And Bang will just constantly be doing damage from the side. But again, I mean, the improvement for Samsung is very notable for sure. They had the right idea at the last Dragon fight too. They had a really good setup. Again, just a slight timing miscommunication, but if it had gone perfect, I think the game might be very different right now. And Samsung, after this Baron buff ends, should still get one last chance. They are pretty far behind, but it's not five Dragons just yet. They can try to make a fight at the fifth Dragon. Of course, Ezion will be that huge bane, and Marin, we saw that Zonya is being completed earlier, has another DLC large rod. So all eyes on Fury now for Samsung, and he did some good damage on Jamarin, but it wasn't enough.
Yeah, Samsung just backing off right now. They can't fight this while the Baron buff is up. And they may be able to buy themselves just a little more time here. SKT probably can't take another inhibitor off of this buff, but yeah, Samsung is just a matter. It seems like when they play teams that we think of as being more skilled than them, like Ku Tigers or Jhin Air.
As Bang just goes forward with the Valkyrie, gets a lot of burst out to Crown, but takes a lot himself, and Crown going back forward just to help clear the wave a little bit with that Orb of Deception. It's going to Spirit Rush back and walk all the way to base before returning. Marn is now here, has that Equalizer, but no minions left for SKT, so it's going to be some time before this inhibitor turret goes down in mid lane.
Yeah, and like I was saying, Samsung, they play well, they have a good strategy, but when it comes down to it, if you can just drag the game out long enough against them, they will make a critical error, whether it's one of decisions or one of executions like we saw. They're going to go
and
in again,
though.
Goes
in and gets a 3-4 man ultimate, but it's just even. Kuvei, no damage follow-up, and Fury finally coming up. QSS on the Hemo play, so he's not taking any amplified damage, but he just isn't in range to do damage to any of these enemy champions. Look at that Equalizer denying the escape and forcing everyone to ditch Kuvei on the side of Samsung.
Yeah, that was a nice try. Crown not there, neither was Marin, but Marin comes in with the Equalizer in the end. And they pushing forward right now. Super minions in the base. Fury trying to get some damage down while he can, but EasyHoon just quickly turning it around. That transfusion healing right back up.
Yeah, Fury just not doing that much damage anymore. Has that last Whisper, has the Bloodthirster for the extra shield and sustain.
Well, it's hard for him to do more damage than he's doing right now. The only thing he can get is a Mercurial Scimitar.
Yeah.
Or upgrade his upgrade to a Phantom Dancer from that Static Shiv. It's about all you're going to get. And so if he's not doing enough now, just through the sustain of EasyHoon, that means he's never going to do enough.
Yeah, I really do wonder if push comes to shove, if Fury might have to consider actually selling that QSS and going for another damage item.
4,000 HP Vlad.
Yeah, I mean, the QSS, sure, you're not dying as quickly, but that Vlad ain't going anywhere if all you're doing is clearing out his Hemoplague on you.
He can just dive forever, too. As long as his Ghost is up, you're not going to escape him. He will just hunt you down in the end.
Well, Ghost is down for this fight, and Fury returning with the fur enchantments on his boots. So this should allow him to get a little bit more mobile to put out more damage across the fight. But with the Equalizer, I mean, Marn's been on point to make sure Fury doesn't get that chance. He can dash in and out to do sustained damage with his auto attacks. Dran's gonna come out. It's gonna go down really quickly by SKT, but SKT, they know they can also just win the fight handily, and they have the speed from the Scuttle Crab. Poke coming in from Bang. And yeah, they're just gonna keep Samsung at bay as the minion wave starts to form in bottom. And look at that dragon getting bursted down. Kuvei marching forward, though. They're trying to deny it, and Wraith goes forward, and three-man pulverize. Equalizer onto Fury yet again, though, on the top side. Charm onto EasyHoon. Explosive cast go down. Eve does steal the dragon. There's the culling, not really hitting anyone at that point. Fury nearly at full health, but gets slowed down as Ban comes over the wall. There's the pulverize, though. Wraith keeping Fury alive at all costs. And Kuvei keeping Tom behind. Now, Marn and EasyHoon are very healthy. Crown does get a charm as Fury comes in from behind, and he's gonna go on to Marn. Marn turns around, and the Zhonya's Flamespitter will pick up the kill. Can Fury get the revenge kill onto Marn? Should be able to. There's the body slam from Tom trying to save his teammate, but it's not gonna happen. Fury, one more hit. Oh, he's not gonna get it. He hits the ward. He dashes forward, and with his passive, gets the double kill. And here's EasyHoon, the ultimate boss. One hit, two hit.
Wow, Fury actually life stealing off that ward right there just to get a little bit more. EasyHoon doing the same thing. He's got to run. Fury's very strong right now.
Yeah, EasyHoon can't.
Another life steal. He wants to get. No, he's not going to pursue this. That's probably smart. He needs to go save his base.
Yeah,
but some impressive mechanics for Fury in that last fight. Bang flashing way too aggressively and getting destroyed by Fury in the 1v1 right around the backside of the pit.
Yeah, I mean, sure, Bang got the advantages the previous couple of fights, but he's not going
to
get it this
Great
time.
Great pulverize to start that one off. Again, Fury starts the fight having to run around in circles thanks to Marin, but Eve gets the smite down. wins the battle, and then a culling to get the initial damage. Hemoblade will go down. Fury actually cleansed it. And then now Fang flashes over, but Wraith, great combo to keep him CC'd while Fury got the necessary damage. And then from this point, it was a little bit of cleanup. Fury goes and takes the red buff right there just to heal up, get that buff, and then heads back right onto Marin.
Yeah, Crown getting caught, was relying on the headbutt. Kube does eventually go down, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, he just gets chased down with Qs and E's.
Yeah, with the ghost activated. And then he realizes he can't really fight Fury too reliably at this point. So Fury has hit that critical point now. He has a Mercurial Scimitar on top of it. He's had that last whisper. He has all the damage he can get. And now it's all a matter of just maybe upgrading based on situation.
It is amazing that Fury can make these plays in this game. He is showing what a quality AD carry he is.
Yeah, 7-2-2 in a game where you are 11,000 gold behind.
Look at this. Wraith has a banner as well, so they're trying to create some split push threat on the map just to last it out.
That is brilliant.
Can they get to six items here where this gold lead really won't mean a whole lot?
Crown also has that second easy large rod. SKT looking for another fight. Now, Baron is up, so if Samsung loses even one member, SKT pretty much will finish the game at 50 minutes in.
Well, their inhibitor's back up now, so that's not going to be a threat anymore. They have side wave pressure. All Samsung has to do is be patient right here.
Oh.
They don't want to face check this.
No. Fury has his Scrying Orb, so he can check it over
the
wall.
They have a ward in the pit, too.
Yeah, so. Marin's going to show up, gets the harpoon onto Kube, gets the slow after taking the Banshee's Veil down, and there is a nice headbutt back onto Tom. Eve comes in from the back and completely eliminates the threat, and the culling goes down onto Wolf. Wolf is down, no Monsoon available for SKT. They cannot disengage as reliably. They're just going to have to get out. Ezion actually using Ghost to ensure that he can get back to the turret.
They have to deal with the super minion or the buffed minion in the top side right now.
This tier 2 in mid is definitely going down, but what about the top lane? How are they going to react to this from SKT? They have to split somehow.
And now, can they do Baron is the question. Marin's TP is up.
Ooh, Tom.
40 seconds. They can try.
They could try it, but this, I mean, this could really end the game.
TP, okay, they're going to try a TP. They're going to bait it and try and TP in and kill them.
All right, well, they have to clear the ward first. They're going to go ahead and put the pink down. They're started
baited
the Baron.
Here's the TP, TP, TP,
yeah,
TP.
And Marin's coming in too. Both TPs coming in from the side. Now, Marin isn't home guarded, and Kuve just runs right into Tom. So Samsung has to disengage from the Baron, and that's all SKT wants. They lost the tier 2, but that's the only thing they lose. Oh, an equalizer to make sure Samsung can't start it again. Does a lot of damage with the Rylai's on top of it. Fury just life-stealing off the blue. They're going to try to give it over to Crown. They succeed in doing so.
Fury doesn't have a lot of mana anymore,
yeah.
However, and they managed to get to a
wow.
point where Wolf is back up. Wolf actually buying an elixir of sorcery right now. It's the point in the game we've come to, apparently.
Well,
he has the Zeke's Herald as well for Bang.
Wolf just really wants those cooldowns to make sure that he can protect his teammates, especially Bang. I mean, Ezion can kind of fend for himself for quite a long time.
Well, coming into this match, SKT did give some respect to Samsung, saying that they weren't going to treat them lightly, that they thought they were a good team, and Samsung's record may be 1-3, but they've been able to hang in there in the best of threes, and it's not really reflecting how well they've played in some of these games. And they've made mistakes this time, which have led to this gold deficit, but they've been so tenacious. And just in terms of individual play, Fury really delivering, and Bang playing overly cocky to close out this game. Now, SKT still knocking on the door with the fifth dragon. They still have a massive advantage in this game.
Yeah.
And we'll see if their play, they're going to have the crab up when the dragon spawns this time. That is huge.
It is pretty big, and SKT, I mean, that's the advantage of having four dragon stacks, is that you know that the enemy is forced to make a call every time it spawns. Gonna, oh, Fury almost getting caught by Bang, and there's an equalizer coming down. He flashes out of it, and there's the QSS. It has to be used. A big one coming in. The charm instantly cleansed on the side of Bang, but Crown takes a buttload of damage from Marin.
Well, that's probably going to be it. There, you just blew your flash on your AD carry and the QSS. We'll
see, but Eve goes in for the flank. Four man ult. Kuve goes in, and there's the calling onto Wolf. But Marin coming in from the side. Fury turns around. He dashes out of the flame spitter, but can he get the damage onto Marin? He gets it. He's still alive. Ezion at full health, though. Bang at about half health. And Wraith is going to have to run away alongside Eevee. He's going to have to protect his teammate. But Ezio coming in with the Ghost. Fury just trying to lifesteal as much as possible. The Ghost does run out from Ezio. Oh, but he gets the Q over the wall. And that should be the game in favor of SK Telecom.
Well, SKT a little bit sloppy in those later game team fights. They're not even going to go for that dragon. Just pushing up the middle. Wolf is here with a sorcery potion. He's going to deal a lot of tree damage with that, actually. He's going to kill him. Eventually.
Eventually, he'll catch up. Well, just trying to deny him from returning to base as Kube and Eve do everything they can to fight this off. Tom taking a lot of tower damage, but it's better than Bang taking it. And Bang's actually pretty low, doesn't have that mana. So Eve, oh, does not escape, gets hit by the last rocket. And, oh, Wraith has successfully dodged the Wind Lady. The heal is doing a lot of work for him. And it should still be the game. 20 seconds until Crown comes back up. I don't think Kube and Wraith can block, especially with Tom with that beautiful body slam to make sure they secure it. Bang just focusing down the Nexus. And SKT picks up the win in game number one after a long 54-minute game.
Still, you got to give some props to Samsung.
Absolutely.
For holding in there for so long. They were down very far behind in mid and top lane farm. They didn't play the map the best in terms of getting objectives early. They fell behind very far in terms of turrets, but when it came down to stalling out SKT's ability to close and even winning some of those late team fights, they really showed their stuff. Marin really was great that game.
Yeah, his rumble, I mean, his ability to just climb back into the game all of a sudden and be this hyper carry and